Good morning, beloved, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Krista Pettiford, hence the channel, and today I want to talk to you about the principle of abiding. I'm going to use, that's my word for the year, is abide. And so when we talk about abiding in something, John 15 says, verse 7 says, if you abide in me and my word abides in you, you will ask what you desire and it will be done for you. By this, my Father is glorified that you bear much fruit. So shall you be my disciples. Before I get into this, I'd like to ask you to subscribe to my channel and to like this video and share it with friends if it blesses you. So the word abide, I've been struggling with the cold, a flu. So first of all, I pick a word for the year, and Pam Farrell, who spoke at my conference this year, does a really good job of helping you select that word and then do some things to focus on it all year. And the main thing that I love that she does is she says, pick a clarifying question. You have a clarifying question. Will this help me abide? Will this help me? Whatever your word is. So you can use this principle. I'm going to use my word abide, but you can use the principle that I'm going to teach this morning to abide in those things, to focus all year long on those things that really matter to you. So I took my word abide, and then I took my four core values and I connected them to the word abide, because when you abide in something, you bear fruit. When you're not scattered all over the place. So the principle of abiding, Jesus gave me that word for my year, to abide in him, not to be distracted, to rest in him, to abide in his word, to abide in truth, to abide. And so what do you need to abide in? What do you need to wrap yourself in and live and dwell in this year? Because when you do that, then you will bear much fruit. So whatever your word is for the year, and again, we pick a word for the year because that's the principle that we want to guide our life. That is the word that we want to come out on the other side of it. So when 2021 comes, God willing, I want to be able to say, I abided in the Lord and I bore much fruit. And that's a really good way to pick your word for the year if you haven't done so yet. At the end of this year, at the beginning of the next year, what do you want more of in your life? So that's how you can pick your word for the year. What do you want your outcome to be? And so I want to abide and I want the fruit of abiding. And so for that reason, that is my word. And so even in the book of Luke, we hear about Mary and Martha. And at the end it says, Mary, Martha, Martha, verse 41, you are worried and troubled about many things, but one thing is needed, and Mary has chosen the good portion that will not be taken away from her. So Mary and Martha were sisters, and Martha was busy serving, and she complained that her sister was just sitting there at Jesus' feet hearing her words and tell her to help me serve, she said. And he said, you're worried and troubled about a lot of things, but one thing is needed. And in some translations, it says one or a few things is needed, and Mary has chosen that portion that will not be taken away from her. And so what do you need to choose? And that's how you choose your word. What is the main thing? And then from that, break it down so that you're not scattered all over the place. Pick one goal that you want to focus on, that you want to focus on, whether it's your spiritual goal, your physical goal, one out of each, just one thing that you want to accomplish at the end of the year in your life that you want to make progress in, and then pick a word that will help connect those things. So I'm gonna use my values and then I'm gonna show you how this works. So my values are truth. I value truth. It is a principle, a guiding principle in my life that I live by. Truth is the word of God. Truth is the opposite of people lying to you. Truth is very important to me because I've dealt with lies and I want to abide in truth. And another word for truth is honesty, or the word of God. So taking that word, truth, and then creativity. I'm a creative person. That's why I'm on YouTube. But I'm an IT manager by day. I'm a left and right brain person, but I have to have creativity in my life. I have to do things like I love to bake and cook and decorate my house and do vision boards and all those things. These things come natural to me and they're my happy place. I love to read and write. Creativity is a principle. Peace is a value. My peace matters to me. And I didn't know how much peace mattered to me until my peace was disrupted by certain things that began to happen in my life about 5 or 6 years ago. And peace matters to me. And so I hold on to my peace and I don't do things that hurt my peace. And then finally, family. I have adult children, believe it or not. I am an empty nester with 4 adult children ranging from 22 to 30. And making time for my children and to spend time with them and connect with them really matters to me. So with that, those are the 4 values. So when I think of abide and all the things that I want to abide in, which is authority, which is the prophetic word that God has given me, and I really thought that was going to be my word. But what I see is that I can take that word abide in the rest of God, abide in authority, in that rest of God where I'm not trying to get what God has already given me, but I'm claiming it. I am declaring and decreeing it. I am declaring heaven's decrees. I am saying what God in heaven says about me from a place of resting in faith and belief in Jesus Christ and trusting his promises and what he has said. So that's number one. And then I'm abiding in truth. That's to abide in his word, to abide in the reality, to check myself when I'm getting out of integrity or when I'm not being led by truth. And then number 3 would be creativity. Am I doing things that are creative? Abide in that creative place. And God is a creator. And so it's no big thing. I mean, it's no wonder that I love to create, that the prophetic gift in me is a creative gift, all these things. So abide in that creative space, and then to abide in peace, to make sure my home is peaceful, my mind is peaceful, and I don't let anything disrupt my peace. And then to abide in family, make space and make room for my family. I'm thinking about downsizing again. I downsized from like 2,500 square feet and now I'm at 1568. And I'm thinking about downsizing a little bit more to give me more freedom financially and in many other ways. But I want room for my 6-person table so that my kids can come over. I want room for them to be able to come and hang out on my couch or an extra room. Family is important to me, even though they're adults. So that's what I'm going to be abiding in. And those are the words, the values that are going to surround my word for the year, which is abide. And so you can take that word abide, or you can take whatever your word is for this year, and you can then go back and say, what are the things that really matter to me? Pick no more than 5. I picked 4, but I like to try and keep it simple. And so take those words and then attach those things. Actually, there's authority, right? So that is 5. But take those things and connect them to your word. Connect them to whatever word that you have chosen. And then hold yourself accountable to that. Am I abiding in peace? Am I abiding in family? Am I abiding in creativity? Am I abiding in authority, or am I worrying? Am I abiding in truth? Or am I whatever, blank, fill in the blank, in fill in the blank, whatever your values are connected to your word for the year. But anyway, beloved, I hope this bless you. This was more of a practical teaching than prophetic. And I hope that it blessed you, and I hope that you get value out of this. Please leave me a note, a message in the comments, and let me know if you picked your word and if this was helpful to you, or if this helped you pick your word. And again, please like the channel, subscribe, like the video, subscribe to the channel, and share it if it blessed you. God bless.